Dynamic relocation using a relocation register. A routine is not loaded until it is called. Our primary assumption of program execution is that a program is loaded into the memory with all the routines that it will call during its execution. However, we can delay the loading of subroutines until they are called. So इसका हमें बेनिफिट क्या होगा अगर हम उन रूटीन्स को लोड नहीं करते जो कि अभी हम जिनकी अभी हमें ज़रूरत नहीं है बल्कि उनको तब लोड करते हैं जब उनको कॉल किया जाएगा. द बेनिफिट विल बी बेटर मेमोरी स्पेस यूटिलाइजेशन बिकॉज नाउ ओनली दैट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज लोडेड इन टू द मेमोरी दैट इज नीडेड. द अननीडेड routines which are not currently required, they are not loaded. So we will achieve better memory space utilization. So unused routines are never loaded. Only those routines will be loaded which are currently required for the program execution. So all the routines are kept on disk in relocatable load format. So whenever a routine will be required, it will be loaded by the linker loader from the disk to the main memory. First, program will check either the routine is available in the main memory or not. If the routine is not available in the main memory, in that case, definitely it is on the disk, on the secondary disk. So in this case, linker loader will load the desired routine from the disk to the main memory. This is known as dynamic loading. This scheme is useful when large amounts of code are needed to handle infrequently occurring cases. It requires no special support from the operating system. The implementation of dynamic loading doesn't need any special kind of operating system support. Rather, the implementation can be achieved through the program design. It is up to the programmer, application developer, that how he implements his program. However, operating system can help by providing libraries to implement dynamic loading. Operating system can assist the programmer by providing libraries or function calls that will help the programmer to implement the dynamic loading. To implement the dynamic loading, as we discussed in the last video, that a relocation register will be required. This relocation register contains the starting address of the process in the main memory. So whenever a CPU will generate the logical address, for example, in this case, this is the address 346. This value will be added to the relocation register. Again, I will repeat again that relocation register ke andar kya hota hai? Iske andar process ka starting address hota hai ki wo memory mein kahan pe stored hai. To us location ka starting address jo hota hai, process ke address space ka, that is stored in the relocation register. So logical address is added to this base address, which is in the relocation register, and then a physical address is generated, which is used to access the main memory for any read or write operation. Remember, relocation registers you have, processes cannot access the relocation register directly. To access these registers, special privileged instructions are required. So any user program, it cannot change the value in the relocation register. Only operating system can load and unload the relocation registers. A similar concept is the dynamic linking. Before this, we discussed the dynamic linking. Let's see what is static linking. Static linking is that system libraries and program code is combined by the loader into the binary program image. That is an executable program, or the binary program image is generated by the linker loader by combining the system libraries and the program code. So this is known as static linking. That is, before a program starts its execution and it is loaded into the main memory, the libraries are linked with the program code. Whereas opposite to this concept is the dynamic linking. In this case, linking of the libraries is postponed until the execution time. That is, libraries will be linked to the program code during the execution. When these libraries will be called, then they will be linked to the program code or with the binary program image. A small piece of code, which is known as stub, is used to locate the appropriate memory resident library routine. So in this case, what will happen? That there will be a stub at those locations in the binary program image where this system libraries are called. And what is this stub? This stub is the piece of code that helps to locate the libraries either in the main memory or from the disk drive. In case when the libraries are memory resident, means they are stored in the main memory, in that case, they are attached to the process address space. However, if the libraries are not in the main memory, rather they are on the disk drive, in that case, stub will locate those libraries from the disk drive, and then they will be brought into the main memory, and then they will be linked to the binary program image. So stub replaces itself with the address of the routine, and then this routine is executed. Operating system checks if routine is in the process memory address space. If it is not in the address space, then it is added to the process address space. Dynamic linking is particularly useful for system libraries. This is also known as shared libraries. System libraries are shared libraries, are those libraries which are shared by multiple programs. For example, printer jo hai, library jo hai, printer device drivers which help other processes to get the print services. This printer library can be dynamically linked with the programs which need printing services. So what will be the benefit of dynamic linking? Consider the applicability to patching system libraries. In case we need to apply patches to system libraries, patches kya hai? Jaise ki hum Windows ke andar dekhte hain ki security holes ke liye jo hai patches jo hai available hote hain, ya jo other system libraries hoti hain unko upgrade karne ke liye patches jo hai, these are the codes which are added to the system libraries which are already present in the operating system. और ये पैचेस जो हैं ये अपग्रेडेशन प्रोवाइड करते हैं, न्यू फीचर्स लाइक ऐड करते हैं, या एग्जिस्टिंग जो फीचर्स होते हैं सिस्टम लाइब्रेरीज इनको इंप्लीमेंट करती हैं, उनको उनकी फंक्शनैलिटी को इन्हांस करने के लिए, उनके अंदर सिक्योरिटी लूप होल्स को जो है ओवरकम करने के लिए हम जो है वो पैचेस जो हैं वो अप्लाई करते हैं. तो इन केस ऑफ पैचेस, व्हेन वी अप्लाई पैचेस टू द सिस्टम लाइब्रेरीज, तो देखो हमें दोबारा से सिस्टम लाइब्रेरीज को या प्रोग्राम कोड को कंपाइल करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. These patches are directly linked, dynamically linked to the system libraries when they are applied. So versioning may be needed. This means a system may kept more than one versions of the system libraries, and different programs, they can use different system, different versions of the same system library. swapping. A process can be swapped temporarily out of the main memory to a backing store device, and then it can be brought back into the main memory for continued execution. So what we can do, we can move or we can transfer a process from the main memory to the backing store, and then we can again transfer it back from the disk drive to the memory for remaining execution. What is the benefit, or why do we need this swapping? Total physical memory space of processes can exceed the physical memory limit. So in this case, for example, if the address space of a process is more than the available memory limit, in that case, what we can do, we can only load the portions of the process which are currently required, and the other parts of the process which are not currently needed, they can be kept on the disk drive. So when those parts are needed, they can be replaced with the parts of the process which are already present in the memory and which has completed their execution. So swapping can help here. We can swap out the parts of the process which have completed their execution, and we can swap in the parts of the process which are now required to complete the execution of the process. Backing store jo hai, a fast disk which is large enough to accommodate copies of all memory image for all users, must provide direct access to these memory images. Another variant of the swapping is roll out and roll in. This variant is used for the priority based scheduling algorithms when there is a high priority process, and when a high priority process enters the system, in that case, we roll out a low priority process from the main memory back to the disk drive, and this high priority process is rolled in. This is how it happens, that lower priority process is swapped out, so higher priority process can be loaded and executed. Major part of swap time is the transfer time. So the main, disadvantage of the swapping is the swap time, which decreases the system performance, or it affects the system performance. Total transfer time is directly proportional to the amount of memory swapped. So this transfer time is proportional to the size of the memory that is being swapped. System maintains a ready queue of ready to run processes which have memory images on the disk. Okay, does the swapped out process need to swap back into the same physical address? Like agar humne ek process ko memory se disk pe transfer kiya aur jab dobara is process ko disk se wapas memory mein leke aayenge to kya wo same memory main memory space occupy karega? Now it depends on the address binding method. कि कौन सी हमने जो है वो बाइंडिंग स्कीम जो है इस्तेमाल की, आइदर कंपाइल टाइम बाइंडिंग इस्तेमाल हो रही है या लोड टाइम बाइंडिंग इस्तेमाल हो रही है या जो है वो एग्जीक्यूशन टाइम बाइंडिंग जो है वो इस्तेमाल हो रही है. सो द आंसर डिपेंड्स टू द पर्टिकुलर बाइंडिंग स्कीम. एंड अनदर कंसिडरेशन इज पेंडिंग आयो टू एंड फ्रॉम प्रोसेस मेमोरी स्पेस. और दूसरा जो है इसका आंसर जो है इस क्वेश्चन का, वो डिपेंड करता है कि जब इस प्रोसेस को हमने स्वाप आउट किया था तो क्या ये कोई आयो ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म तो नहीं कर रहा था. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस प्रोसेस वाज वेटिंग फॉर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ सम आयो ऑपरेशन, एंड व्हाइल इट वाज वेटिंग फॉर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर आयो ऑपरेशन, हमने जो है इसको स्वाप आउट कर दिया. सो दिस इज अनदर फैक्टर दैट नीड्स टू बी कंसिडर्ड to answer this question. So As far as this address binding method is concerned, if we are using compile time or load time address binding scheme, then the process must be swapped back into the same memory location जहां से हमने इसको swap out किया था. तो however अगर हम execution time जो है binding इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं तो उस केस में जो है ये जरूरी नहीं है कि हम इसको सेम मेमोरी स्पेस के अंदर जो है वो दोबारा से स्वाप इन करें जहां से हमने इसको स्वाप आउट किया था. और इसी तरह जहां तक ये दूसरा फैक्टर है इसकी बात है, तो अगर तो प्रोसेस कोई भी पेंडिंग आयो नहीं है तो प्रोसेस को किसी भी नए मेमोरी एड्रेस पे स्वाप इन किया जा सकता है. हाउएवर अगर जो है प्रोसेस किसी पेंडिंग आयो ऑपरेशन का वेट कर रहा है तो उस केस में जो है प्रोसेस को उसी एड्रेस स्पेस पे स्वाप इन किया जाएगा जहां से हमने इसको स्वाप आउट किया था. मॉडिफाइड वर्जन ऑफ स्वापिंग आर फाउंड ऑन मेनी सिस्टम्स. फॉर एग्जांपल यूनिक्स, लिनक्स एंड विंडोज जो है दे यूज द मॉडिफाइड वर्जन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड स्वापिंग स्कीम. नॉर्मली जो है स्वापिंग इज डिसेबल्ड ऑन दीज सिस्टम्स. However, it can be enabled if more than threshold amount of memory is allocated. And it can be disabled again once the memory demand reduced below that threshold value. So, on these systems, Unix, Linux, ya Windows system pe kya hota hai ke swapping jo hai normally disabled hoti hai. Lekin agar jo hai memory usage jo hai certain value se exceed karta hai, which is the threshold value, उस वैल्यू से एक्सीड करता है तो स्वैपिंग जो है उसको अनेबल कर दिया जाता है. लाइक मेमोरी बहुत ज्यादा यूटिलाइजेशन, उसकी यूटिलाइजेशन बहुत एक्सीड कर जाती है तो उस केस में जो है हम स्वैपिंग को अनेबल कर देते हैं. हाउएवर जब वो मेमोरी डिमांड जो है दोबारा से रिड्यूस हो जाती है, डिक्रीज हो जाती है, तो हम दोबारा से स्वैपिंग को डिसेबल कर देते हैं. दिस डायग्राम गिव्स द view of swapping, how it happens. This is the main memory. Main memory के अंदर जो operating system stored है, as well as this is the user space जिसके अंदर जो user processes हैं. So initially, suppose there was the process P1 which was in the main memory, and another high priority process P2 needs to be brought into the main memory. So what we will do? We will swap out the process P1 back to the disk storage, or process P2 जो है उसको swap in करेंगे ताकि वो अपनी execution जो है start कर सके. So context switch time including swapping. If next process to be put on CPU is not in the main memory, then it has to be swap out a process and swap in the target process. कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच टाइम कैन बी वेरी हाई. लाइक ये जो कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच हो रहा है कि हम एक प्रोसेस जो है उसको स्वाप आउट कर रहे हैं और एक दूसरा प्रोसेस जिसकी हमने एग्जीक्यूशन स्टार्ट करनी है उसको स्वाप इन कर रहे हैं, तो दिस इज नोन एज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच टाइम. द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू स्वाप आउट अ प्रोसेस एंड टू स्वाप इन अनदर प्रोसेस, दिस ड्यूरेशन इज नोन एज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच टाइम. For example, if there is a 100 MB process swapping to the hard disk with the transfer rate of 50 MB per second, so swap out time hume kitna required hoga? 2000 millisecond ya 2 second hume required honge, because 50 MB can be transferred per second, so 100 MB ko transfer karne ke liye we need 2 seconds or 2000 milliseconds. Moreover, we also need to determine the swap in time of the same size process. Or agar ek dusra process jisko hum swap in kar rahe hain uska size bhi same hai 100 MB, or this is the transfer rate, to swap in time bhi 2000 millisecond hoga. To total time kitna ho jayega context switch ka? 4000 millisecond. 2000 for the swap out and 2000 for the swap in, to total time jo hai that will be 4 second. This time can be reduced if we reduce size of the memory swapped. For example, अगर हमें ये पता है कि जो incoming process है उसको कितनी memory required है, तो in that case जो है हम सारा का सारा process है उसको हमें swap out करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है जो कि already memory के अंदर था. We can only swap out the part of its address space that is required for the incoming process. So the system calls to inform operating system of memory use can be used in this context. These system calls are request memory and release memory. इसके अलावा दूसरे फैक्टर्स जो हैं दैट अफेक्ट द स्वैपिंग दैट इज द पेंडिंग आयो जिसको मैंने ऑलरेडी डिस्कस कर चुका हूँ कि पेंडिंग आयो क्या है कि अगर एक प्रोसेस जो है जिसको हम स्वैप आउट कर रहे हैं इट वाज इन द मिडल ऑफ आर इट वाज वेटिंग फॉर सम आयो ऑपरेशन तो वी कैन नॉट स्वैप आउट एज आयो वुड अकर टू द रॉन्ग प्रोसेस तो इस प्रोसेस को स्वैप आउट नहीं किया जा सकता क्योंकि अगर हम इसको स्वैप आउट कर देते हैं तो इसकी जो एड्रेस स्पेस थी जो जहाँ पे मेमोरी में ये स्टोर था वहाँ पे अब ऑब्वियसली एक नया प्रोसेस आके स्टोर हो जाएगा तो ये जो आयो ऑपरेशन जब कंप्लीट होगा तो ये आयो जो है ये इस प्रोसेस के साथ कम्युनिकेट करेगी जो कि उस अब एड्रेस स्पेस पे आके स्टोर होगा तो ये एक दूसरा प्रोसेस है तो आयो जो है वो रॉन्ग प्रोसेस के साथ हो रही है अब इस प्रॉब्लम को हम कैसे सॉल्व कर सकते हैं एक तो सोल्यूशन ये है कि उसको स्वैप आउट ही ना करें बट दिस इज नॉट a feasible solution. So what we can do, we can always transfer IO to the kernel space. कि हम जो है IO जो है उसको kernel space के through जब transfer करें and then to the IO devices. For example, process से जो है वो पहले कोई भी input output operation है तो process से पहले kernel space के अंदर जाएगा kernel से जब वो IO device को जाएगा similarly IO device से वो वापस kernel space में आएगा और kernel space से IO जाए तब जो है वो फिर प्रोसेस की तरफ ट्रांसफर होगी तो इन दिस केस दिस इज नोन एज डबल बफरिंग बिकॉज टू टाइम्स बफरिंग हो रही है पहले जब प्रोसेस से वो कर्नल और कर्नल से फिर आयो में जाती है और सिमिलरली जब वो आयो से वापस कर्नल और कर्नल से फिर प्रोसेस में जाती है तो दिस इज द डबल बफरिंग एंड ऑब्वियसली दिस इज एन ओवरहेड सिस्टम परफॉर्मेंस विल बी अफेक्टेड स्टैंडर्ड स्वैपिंग नॉट यूज्ड इन मॉडर्न ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स बट मॉडिफाइड वर्जन इज कॉमन ये भी मैं ऑलरेडी हम डिस्कस कर चुके हैं कि विंडोज के अंदर या लिनक्स के अंदर जो है स्टैंडर्ड स्वैपिंग इस्तेमाल नहीं होती स्वैपिंग सिर्फ तब अनेबल होती है जब मेमोरी यूजेज जो है वो बहुत हाई होता है स्वैप ओनली व्हेन फ्री मेमोरी बिकम्स एक्सट्रीमली लो ओके वी विल नॉट डिस्कस दी स्वैपिंग ऑन मोबाइल सिस्टम्स